Good morning, you two. How's everybody doing here on the YTPC? It's your good friend, the Piano Piper. And I'm coming at you guys on this beautiful Saturday morning to do a tobacco first impressions video. And the tobacco that we're going to be checking out today is Gawith and Hoggarth's Black Cherry Twist. And this is another one of the generous portions of tobacco that Onion, aka 2 AM Pipe on the Patio, sent me to try. So, I'll show you the tobacco real quick. It's a rope, twist, whatever you want to call it. Very moist. Trying to get a just a very dark, deep, aged tobacco smell. There's some smokiness, some woods smelling scents going on. But mainly, it is just a strong tobacco smell. It smells delicious. I'm not getting any cherry smell at all, kind of like the Gawith and Hoggarth sweet maple twist that I tried a week or two ago. Didn't smell any maple on that at all. Near the very end of the bowl, I could taste it, but it was very, very faint. So I'm wondering if this is going to be the same kind of deal. So, as I said, it was very moist in the twist. I cut off like 4 coins and I crumpled them up, and they've been airing out for like 1.5 hours. We'll see if that was enough time. But before we get to that, I've got a few shout outs to take care of. Some new subscribers to my channel. So, the first one is The Truth, thanks for the sub. Jeffrey Elton Carter, thank you for the sub, my friend. Not Alone, thanks for the sub. Richard T, thank you for subscribing. Scotty Dashboard, thanks for the sub. And last but not least is Braun, Rose, and Briar. Thanks for the sub. And if I missed you and didn't give you a shout out, by all means, in the comment section below, please feel free to let me know that you were missed, and I will shout you out in the next video. So, without further ado, we will get down to business here. As I said, it's been airing out for about 1.5 hours. About 4 coins there. It's probably more than I need. And it is still a little tacky, but I think it's probably good enough to smoke. So I'm going to pack the pipe, and I will be right back. All right, guys. I'm back. And I just wanted to show you, this is about the size, thickness of the coin that I've cut. Hopefully that can focus so you guys can see that beautiful tobacco. It is nice. Very, very nice. So, on tobaccoreviews.com. The brand is Gawith and Hoggarth. It's blended by Gawith and Hoggarth. It's manufactured by Gawith and Hoggarth. The blend type is an aromatic. The contents is Burley and Virginia. The flavoring is black currant and other. The cut is rope or twist. The packaging comes in bulk. The country is the United Kingdom. The production is currently available. And you can get it at smokingpipes.com, among other brick and mortars if you are lucky, and some other online sites as well. But this is the only one they had listed on tobaccoreviews.com. The strength is strong. The flavoring is very mild. The taste is medium to full. And the room note is tolerable. And out of 4 stars, it has a 2.3 star rating. And they did emphasize on tobaccoreviews.com website, this is a very strong tobacco because it doesn't undergo some of the cooking processes that typical pipe tobaccos go through. So you probably want to be sitting down while you smoke this one. A little housekeeping. I'm going to be smoking the Black Cherry Twist in my Stanwell Vario 64 model, 9mm. Love this pipe. Let's get down to it. I packed it a little loose because it is still a little bit moist. On the initial charring light, I'm getting a mild sweetness in the background, but the main thing I'm tasting is the Burley and Virginia tobaccos. There's a sweetness there, but it's not resembling cherry. I believe it's probably just the Virginia's, that sweet hay, grassy taste coming through. Sorry about that, guys. I exceeded my memory on my cell phone, so the video cut out. So, I think I was talking about the sweetness of the Virginia, that grassy hay taste that's coming through. Getting some of the burley as well. The retro hail is very nice, smooth, and I can pick up some of that hay, woodsy, grassy aroma in my nostrils when I'm retrohaling. The smoke is very smooth, almost creamy, almost like it almost leaves a little bit of a film in my mouth. If you like tobaccos that you taste the tobacco and not the topping, as I think I said with the maple twist, then this is definitely one for you to pick up and give a shot. This mainly is just a nice, smooth tobacco flavor. I'm not getting any cherry at all. Zero. That retrohale is almost a little peppery in the nostrils at times. It's probably because it's such a strong tobacco. This would definitely be a good after dinner tobacco, for me anyway. Sit out here on the deck and just enjoy the sip it. Smoke is a little bit warm, a little bit warmer than I remember the maple twist being. And I'm still having a hard time keeping it lit, so probably a little bit more dry time would have been better. I gave it about an hour and a half. Maybe try 2 hours and see what happens, because I still hear a little bit of crackling in the pipe. Not getting any tongue bite from it. Overall, it's just a good, classic, tobacco-tasting tobacco. If you like tasting the burleys and the Virginias and not the topping, get yourself some. It's really tasty. Well, guys, I'll leave it there. Until next time, I hope everybody's doing good, being safe, And as always, keep the pipe warm. Take care, guys.